A package arrived for you. It's on your desk. Homicide, come in, this is dispatch. Homicide, come in. Homicide, are you there? Hey, there's a call for you guys down at Church of St. Vincent de Paul. Uniforms are already on scene. This is a weird one. Thank you.
more unsettling. I was called at from one of the cells by an inmate who seemed to know me. Not of me, but my actions over the last few months. He knew about my work. Wow. Not only has he been locked in there for years, only a select few clergymen are aware of my intentions, and they're dismissive at that. The guards quickly ushered me out, and I won't be back there for at least 2 months. Severely opposed to my presence. He wouldn't let me nor my guide step foot in his home. And though we tried to convince him otherwise, we eventually chose to abide his wishes and prepared for a night on the streets outside their home. We sat below her window. Just above our heads, we could hear her strained cries through the night. The hours drew on. We tried to reason with her father again, but he was as stubborn as I persisted. We all raised our voices. She must have heard us as we argued in the street below, because she let out a scream with such ferocity that I thought a pack of wild dogs must be in her room. We raced upstairs, and I was right behind her father as he flung open the door. The sight inside was like nothing I'd seen before. A broken young girl, her body twisted and fractured, devoid of life, innocent. Thank you.
Thank you.